Hello YouTube, today at powerjackrepair.org we got a Dell laptop where we're gonna replace the jack, Dell Inspiron 13 7000 2-in-1 P83G P83G001. Alright, so the client states the jack is faulty, we're gonna replace the jack. We're probably gonna chop off this cord as well because there's too much bending going on right here. Too much bending means the cables probably on the inside already ripped apart, or well, here, let's see. Yeah, I mean, this is just not gonna work. I mean, this is just, so what I'm gonna do is I'm basically gonna just chop off the cord. Disconnect it from the power supply, chop off the cord. And I will need to keep the tip for testing purposes in the future. Alright, do something like that. Well, don't need the tip. No, don't really need. Well, keep the tip. We'll strip the wiring and connect the new tip to this power supply. The power supply isn't that powerful, so any Chinese replacement tip is gonna be just fine. Here we got three cables instead of two cables. We got the black one is probably the ground. Alright, we got the blue, which is probably data signal. Alright, and we got the white one, that's probably a plus. So let's measure this whole thing and see which one is which. Just when I'm saying I'm gonna chop off the cord, I would rather show you, you know, that the cord is already chopped. It's faster to chop it then. Alright, so the power supply is working. So we got, this is the plus, this is the minus, and this is the data signal. Yep, okay. I will get to that in a bit. Let me show you how I'm gonna replace the connector. Just those connectors are kind of hard to get nowadays because of all of the what's going on in the world. Anyways, let's see, does it do autofocus? So it doesn't do the autofocus. Just want to make sure the focus not going to be jumping. Give me 1 second here. Alright, yeah, there is the autofocus that's on right now. And let me shut it down. Let me focus on the laptop. Okay, so screws. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Alright, so I can count to 10. There might be screws under this pad or that pad, but maybe not, because those screws are kind of heavy duty. So I'm figured if I just gonna put a guitar pick. Somebody was already trying to open it up, you see that right there. Be extremely careful because the edges are extremely sharp on this laptop, the aluminum edges. They can cut your fingers easily. Alright, so like that, like that, like that. Good job. Now, let's, so, a rubber padding from the speaker probably. Let's flip it over. Get all the stuff out of here. Alrighty. Somebody forgot to screw down the battery. And those screws are probably flying all over the motherboard, shorting the motherboard someplace. So what I wanna do, let's see, maybe the screws are around the speakers. No. All right. So I need to add the screws right here. Screws right there. Let's do it right now, because otherwise I'm gonna forget about it. So here, That's one. That's two. And those are the clients texting instead of calling. That's a good thing because I don't have to interrupt the repair process. All right, so this is all secure now, right? And that's good, that's good. Okay, that's also good. Let's see. So it's pretty easy replacement. I mean, any one of you can do it. It's basically right here. If you find another cable and the jack, somebody really has many questions. All right. So like that. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna connect a new. I just want to inspect those connections right here to have any burr marks. If they have a burr mark, that means yeah, I mean, this is again the simplest system to work on because the jack is right here. This is a really good laptop, except that it's a bit heavy because of the glass screen, and it's not a matte screen, so it's always gonna cause headache to the client. So here what we're gonna do is this, let's see, this is gonna be, oh yeah, 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 let me get this guy. Okay, so our design of the jack and the back is, let's start this wire and see what exactly this is gonna be. All right. So this is, all right, so we get all of the glue out. This is gonna be a black cable, I assume. And that's a black one. So that's a black one. All right, then we got the second cable. All right, that's the red wire. And this is the white wire on the bottom. White. Well, let me show you how this is gonna look like. So red, white, and black, right? Okay. Now we're just gonna cut these guys out a little bit more. Okay. And the problem with those jacks, you could never know how the connector got disconnected in the back because there is a heat shrink on top of the cable, and that heat shrink keeps the cable kind of attached to the area where the jack is at. So it's really hard to say if the jack is faulty or not because that cable, the rip in the cable is not really visible because it's under the heat shrink, and the heat shrink will always kind of cover up any damage, so you'll never be able to see. And it also gonna keep the wire in place, so you can wiggle it for a long time before it gives out. So here we're gonna remove the heat shrink the best we can. All right, the reason I want to remove all the heat shrink because I will have to solder, and the heat shrink is just gonna get in the way of the soldering iron. And once the soldering iron gets some heat shrink on it, it's gonna smell pretty bad. So here, all right. And all right, good job. All right, like that. Okay, so we need to find exactly the same jack. Give me 1 second. Okay, so here is the brand new jack right here, and the goal is to solder everything up. Okay, so that's the old one right here. That's the old one, and that's the new one. Pretty much similar design, but this is made by a company. I'm not sure which company it's made on by. This is a synchrotron. This is much more heavy duty part for this particular laptop. Mostly synchrotron makes the best connection. So black one goes right there, red one goes right on the top, and the white gonna go on the bottom. So let's switch to the soldering view. Okay. And let's power up the light, music, soldering iron, protection. Alright, just trying to get some focus here. Oh, that looks good, right? Yeah, okay. So, doesn't go exactly as I was planning. Okay. So the goal now is to check and see if the current is going to be conducted to the motherboard. Nope, nothing. Hmm? Oh yeah, okay. All right, that does work. And the positive is fine too. On the white cable. All right, so we're good. And I'm just measuring to make sure that there is no shortage between the red, black, and white, and there is no shortage. So we're good to go now. But that's not it, guys. There is one more crucial step that everyone needs to do. Let's see which way. Alright, so the red should be on that side, right? Like that. Yeah, no. I think, yeah. But nothing's happening. Let's do the other way. Well, the other way fits in better. Strange. All right, so here we need to guide the wires out of the way, out of the hinges way, and guide the whole connector in there and screw it down like that. So just put the screw right there, and yeah. But this is not over. Stay tuned. Alrighty, and here is what we need to do. Alrighty, and that was hot glue, which gonna keep the jack in place, and it's not gonna let it move ever, so that we will never see this laptop here ever again for a power jack repair. And the next thing we need to do is replace the plug on the power supply. Alrighty, so I put the new cable right here, spliced it up. Well, you see how I spliced it, basically just soldered the three cables to the new plug. And we need to get the green light right there. Here we need to get the voltage right here, and we don't get anything because I probably soldered the cables incorrectly. Or did I? Yeah, no. All right, that's 20 volts. That's really strange. For some reason, sometimes I get 20 volts, sometimes I get 2 volts. Let me see how it's gonna behave with the new jack. Alright, so what I'm doing here, I'm connecting the plug, the jack, which I just installed on that laptop, and I wanna double check. Yep. Yeah, so this is a data signal and that's the plus, so everything is fine when it comes to the plug. Oh, need to put the jack back in place. Alrighty, so now that the glue has hardened right here, glue is hard enough, it's gonna prevent the jack from moving up, down, left, right. We're gonna put the back cover in place. And let me shut down the ventilation. The exhaust fan needs to be shut down so that you would be able to hear me sometime. Alright, so here I can see the problem. First of all, this thing needs to be, extra glue needs to be cut off right here. Alright, everything else seems to be connected. I hope nobody screwed around with this laptop prior to me working on this. So here, like that, like that, like that, like that. And we want to double check if the holes align, and they don't align for some reason. Let's see, maybe we need to clamp it down a little bit more. Here it doesn't align well. Let me see if we put the screw in there, maybe it's gonna align. Let's take a look right now. Not 100% what I would want to see. The hole right there does not perfectly align with the casing. There are several reasons that might be the case, but it should be aligning, because otherwise the new plug will drag the the center pin outwards, and then there's always going to be a pressure there for the, okay, let's see, again, sharp edges, so have to be extremely careful, okay, all right. Okay. So what can I do here? What can I do? Okay, so I can see that this piece right there is supposed to be putting a pressure onto. So here I need to cut this guy out, because it's currently right where the glue is at, and the glue is holding everything much better than this thing would. So that's gonna be cut from here and cut from right there. All right, that's one thing. We need to remove this, we need to remove that pad. All right, we also need to probably shave a little bit right here, because extra glue sticking up top prevents the casing to lay flat, prevents the casing from laying flat on the surface of the jack. And let's see, I want to see if there's wiring right here in a way, in any shape or form. No, they're not. They should be fine. Alright, so this is going here. Okay. Alright. Just trying to straighten up the top edge so that, and remove some extra stuff right here. Again, so that the case would be flush against the whole thing right here. Okay. Okay. Hopefully it's not the coronavirus that's going around right now. All right. Let's see. So again, this is the easiest system to work on. We got 1,000+ videos of different makes and models of power check repairs, but this one is the easiest one because it's right there. All right, this one we just leave alone because it's not okay. And there was no screw for it anyway. So let's see, moment of truth. We put HP connectors on the top here because Dell does not really makes the aftermarket plugs, so we have to deal with HP plugs. And by the way, that's an HP jack, and maybe HP makes this Dell. Alright, so nothing shows up. Oh yeah, there is a light right here that shows up. Okay, that's a good sign. So the light shows up. Let's power it up, see, maybe it's gonna work. The keyboard lights up and the Dell screen is right there. Alrighty, so here it shows that it's charging. Health is excellent of the battery, and AC adapter is being recognized, and it's charging, so 0.1%, and it's going up, and it recognizes the power supply at 45 watts. All right, so thanks so much for watching, and you guys have a good day. If you have exactly the same laptop, you can send it to us, or you can buy the parts from us. The link should be below. We sell those parts pretty much to anyone who wants to buy. You might be better off buying the jack and the cable and just replace that, but you know, some of those jacks and cables for sale have reverse polarities on the pluses and minuses, so be careful what you put into your laptop, because you match for the motherboard forever. Forever and ever. Thanks so much. Have a good day.